put them through a lot today.
Fuck these people. Fuck your cause. That shit's over. Ireland's not the only thing that's green. Dollars are too.
Now you I'm super excited for this too, because
take the needle out your arm, then tell me what to do.
It's given a lot of people that we couldn't get to play on 360 the opportunity to play something by just putting in their X1 and being able to retroactively download the update and play. So it's really opened up a lot, and you might actually see while we're doing this that you're going to see people coming on that that I know that play and are playing GTA 4. And it's just, there's a big testament to a game that can be out for, I mean, this has been, you know, a lot of years here, and be out of the struggle, and then have the retro on the X1 and have a lot of people come back and play it. I don't have the complete edition. These are actually my games from when I actually played it before. And I don't have the, was it, I think it's Chinatown Stories or whatever the other one was. I have played that before, but I haven't played it yet for the, obviously with the Xbox One. And I plan on doing a playthrough and putting some other stuff on the YouTube channel at youtube.com/VIP Primo. Same as here, VIP, P-R-I-M-O. So, but that's the thing is, I mean, here we are playing this. It really brings up the idea of what is next for GTA. And the big thing that we've come across right now that's really important is that Take-Two has come over on the side of it's not time to give up GTA Online yet, and said that they wanted to do more updates. I have to be honest, I think that the import-export DLC was really the last. We had the bikers, we had the other thing, and then with this last one coming out, I think this was supposed to be the thing that kind of capped it off and said, that's it. They probably still provided a level of support to the game, but that was the swan song for GTA Online. And now Take-Two has already come out and said, I think I've even said this to the show before, is they can't give it up. It's their cash cow. And I don't mean to say that in a bad way, because it's a fun game. We've done a lot with it. Obviously, microtransactions are what they are. They're a chosen thing. They're not forced on us. And they still managed to make a ton of money for the company. So the reality is that the more money they make, obviously the more money goes back into their games, and the more money comes back into GTA 6. And I think that's why they did the retroactive for GTA 4, was that this is going to be another influx of money that comes into them that allows them to be able to play with what comes up in GTA 6. So does Rockstar have a plan for GTA 6? The thing that I keep hearing over and over again is that it's going to be an MMO. And for that reason, we've seen a lot of support that it's going to be a test, I think, for what's coming up on GTA 5. So GTA 5 Online, the next stuff that we're going to see is going to be a test of the stuff that I think was originally idealized for the game. I think the next big thing, and a lot of you guys out there are going to agree with me on this, is a police update is just a guarantee. The other thing I'd like to give a shout out to Steve from Los Santos for his awesome video with off-road vehicles and off-road ideas. I think a lot of that is going to be implemented. Some of it obviously won't be able to, but unlike the last one that was really done from GTA Wise Guy, this one I think has a lot more opportunity to be put into the game. But before his comes out, and I think they'll need to do a little bit more work to get to something like that, if that they get the support that they need, which are already up to thousands of signatures. If you have a chance to go out and check it out, we'll try to put the link on YouTube so you guys can see it later. It's really going to be an awesome update. But before they get to that, I think any expansions to the maps and a police DLC, which has been in the planning for quite some time. So I think that's got to be the first two things that we're going to see. Now, when will we see something like that? It's a great question. It really, I don't think GTA was ready, or Rockstar was ready for this changeover that suddenly was first we're wrapping up everything, and next it's, you know what I mean? Here it is, like, oh great, we're still in business, guys. Let's go back to work. And how much of those resources are being put into Red Dead? Now, people always tell me that they split resources up between games and they do other stuff. To me, I don't agree with that. Having had friends that were in the industry, there's one thing that I learned is that people who are dedicated to the system are just dedicated to the system. If you're a Rockstar GTA Online guy, then you're a Rockstar GTA Online guy. The guys that are doing GTA 6 now didn't get pulled off of GTA Online to go do, or pulled off of that just to do Red Dead Redemption. It's not the way it works. You get a studio that's dedicated to that product because you don't want people that are going to be splitting up their hairs between different, you know, concepts that are in there. Obviously, there's people that are going to switch or maybe be used in different areas. In other words, hey, I need a gunshot sound, or I need the sound of a car or a horse or something like that. And, man, I knew that was going to happen. and some of those guys do have a split job. So there's going to be people that say, you know, I do sound, so I can do sound on any game. But the reality is that the Rockstar team that's doing Rockstar's Grand Theft Auto Online is Rockstar's Grand Theft Auto Online team. They're not going to go back and forth between one team or the next, or, you know, split differences over time. It's just, this is their job, and that's how it works. So, now, is that, do I know that 100%? No, I don't. But I do know that if you're going to say, if Take-Two has the ability to say, hey, by the way, we're going to do some more of this GTA Online stuff because it's making us money, you certainly can't do that if your team has already moved over to Red Dead Redemption. They can't, because they're going to be busy doing something else, and you definitely don't want to cut into your Red Dead Redemption time to be able to move over to this new product, this old product that, you know, may or may not make you money over a certain period of time. So really what it is these guys that are going to say, hey, we're going to move over to working on the GTA 6 version of online, maybe, or, you know, what's some stuff that we're going to brainstorm, or these are the upkeep items that we're going to assess, or that kind of thing. They're just going to move over from one thing or antiquate to something else. So right now, they're back doing their regular job. So before they get any time off, their gears went right back to full speed. So I think it's going to be a point where, you know, what do we do? How do we get ready for this? How do we make it happen in a way that's going to be productive and give the people what they want? So that's the reality, is they're going to use stuff that they've had since the beginning. And that was maps, that was the cop DLC, that was a lot of different things that have been discussed by a lot of different guys about what's next in it. And I think that's really going to be testing the idea that GTA 6 should be a full-blown MMO. Now, there's something that really worries me about that concept, too, is that GTA 6 as a full MMO means that we may not have much of a single-player experience in comparison to what we're used to. And to be honest, I'm not against that, but I think if we're going to do it, we got to do it in the right way. We have to provide the thing that I've been saying over and over again, is that multiplayer mission challenge story. It can't be like Forza kind of thing. The thing is, I say Forza because, like, if you play Midnight Club, for instance, there's a story associated with it. But if you play Forza, there's no story, there's no characters, there's nothing. You just go in and race and do whatever you want to do. And GTA is a story. It's all about telling this tale that your characters are involved in. Now, the fun part about that is we could do a little bit of Liberty City retroactive with GTA 6, add all these other cities, and kind of even build up to what became the online characters for this GTA game that we're playing now. Like, in other words, you know, kind of a prequel thing. Or we could continue to run with those characters, which I think would be easily has to be the best way of doing it. taking the characters we have and just saying, that's it. We gotta run with this. We gotta let people continue to take their characters from whatever system to whatever system and make it happen. Do you know what I mean? So that's a big deal. I think people who are going to be connected to this game, who are going to be connected to the game for a long time, that would be some amazing stuff. I mean, imagine having your characters that are the characters you started playing with back in 2013 and saying, you know, I still got my same character. You know what I mean? That would just be so exciting for me, and just easily the best way of doing it, because it would keep us attached to a game that, you know, is fluid. And do the same thing with the shark cards again. I know it sounds weird, but, you know, keep the same characters over again and, you know, make it a game where we're attached to it. We're attached to our characters. We're attached to, you know, the way we're playing, what we're doing. Or, you know, I'm sure everybody has played GT Online, has, you know what I mean, dedicated some time to some backstory on the character. And that's one thing that GTA 6 could do that no other game could do, is give us a sort of telltale version of that story, giving us the ability to tell a story, roll with it, create it, design that. In other words, if I want to say my character's a police officer that's coming up in Los Santos and having a tough time breaking in or doing something like that, that's an option. And you can do it with that sort of Claude-esque GTA 3 thing where the guy doesn't talk that much, but the characters kind of feed into him and give him something to do over time. That would be fun to do. That would be fun to play. We get invested in it. I'm really determined whether I would play a race car driver or if I do, you know, the cop guy. But whatever it was, it would be fun. I'd probably have two characters. I always had that motorcycle MC dude. I always had the other guy was always the famous race car driver that was an ex-cop or whatever. I mean, you can tell how these stories get advanced. And the stories came from something that didn't exist. That we never had that story. We're going to race online, or we're going to do this, or we can do this mission, or play this and play with other people. And those things kind of just happen. And if you were allowed to more well-round your character based on the story in the game by making choices or being able to make different choices down the road, it would be exciting. Or the one thing that I was thinking too was not just close it down to say, hey, I'm going to follow this path, and I'm going to follow this path, and I'm going to follow this path, because we have guys like Lester. We have, I'll spit it out, Martin Madroza. All those dudes have different paths that you're really following in their story to get their story complete. And that's the only difference in single player versus the multiplayer, is that you have characters that are dedicated, and there's kind of a, I guess the other thing too is it's harder to dedicate to a character when it's their character. Do you know what I mean? Like, nothing against Franklin or Michael or Trevor. Those are really, really cool characters. And they'll be really cool characters even if they're NPCs. But that's the thing is I'm not Trevor and I'm not Michael, and that's playing somebody else's role. And even then, that's fun. So I'm only imagining what it would be like if, you know, I'm going to follow Crazy Ron's storyline, or if I'm going to play Trevor's storyline, or, you know, I'm going to be one of the guys that helps TPI become big, and each different story unlocks each different thing. And that's the other thing too, is it can't be dedicated to money. The shark cards need to be the shortcut to the mission storyline and the way it's going to pan out down the road. So if I say I'm going to be a police officer and I help Trevor, how's that going to unlock? You know, 'cause I play the first cop mission and now I have to play Trevor's mission, and how do I unlock things for Trevor's mission? So maybe Trevor's missions unlock off-road vehicles or unlocks a meth lab that we work on, and that way you buy the meth lab and you still have your regular missions. And those meth lab missions are still replayable in a way that allow me to unlock different things the next time I play them. And those things are all still for purchase. It would be very exciting. And that's the other thing is it's been tried in GTA Online when we had things like, you know, you had to win a certain amount of races to get your mods up. And a way of doing it so that we could keep things nice and fair was to say, let's make it a race division. So you continually build up that race, and ever how well you do determines how well you do down the road. And if you get, let's say, a sponsor, and that's going to be a livery for your car. Or, I mean, it doesn't have to be this, you know, really crazy stuff that you're unlocking, but the idea of being able to unlock an RE7B down the road by playing the game and doing well at it, and then you show it off to your friends like, hey, guess what? I played online, I did this well, and I got the RE7B. Sometimes that's luck, sometimes it's skill, sometimes it's a little bit of mix of both, but it's still the idea that you're getting rewarded for playing the game. And that's the one thing that I see currently in GTA Online that I don't feel. I feel that my only reward is money, and that money reward doesn't really pay off down the road, because there comes a point when, what do I do with the money? Oh, I bought a car. Okay, what did I do with a car? Nothing. I just sat in my garage. So why am I going on import-export missions when... And that's the other thing is people tell me, well, don't grind heists or don't grind missions. Well, that's what you're doing. I mean, you're really just doing import-export to grind out money. And what are you buying with it? You know, machine guns for the lobby? It doesn't make a lot of sense for me. And doesn't attach people long term. I really feel like that the reason that you're getting a lot of the purchases of shark cards that you're getting now are because it's kids who just want to go online and shoot each other for 4 hours straight and yell into the microphone, and that's not getting people to want to play your game more. That's getting people that go, hey, it's better for me to play, you know, whatever new game is out at the time that's going to be, you know, less screechy or squeakery when I play it. So those are things that have to be taken into account when you're designing this game. And that's not like a weekend warrior kind of design. It's got to be something where you're going to be, you know, dedicated to it down the road.
Oh, great. I might just take a vacation then.
Come on. I was kidding. The clubs fell apart without you. So that bank robbery on the news could have been an opportunity for some positive PR.
Fuck that.
So to move back to GTA 4 right now, I have to say that I am, I can't believe how, you know, like, this game, even though it's played a little bit differently than the way we play GTA 5, I got to say it has aged very, very, very well. And well worth the, you know what I mean? Playability of it is just, you know, I still feel like playing it. I still feel like I've done it. And funny enough, I've actually done, I actually did a couple of run-throughs already before in kind of prep for the stream, if you will. I was amazed that just... I'm just amazed at how well this game has held up and withstood the test of time.
This is Tony. You haven't gotten hold of me, so give Jesse a call if this is concerning Masonette. Troy, if it's Hercules. Or Luis, if it's important. Love you. Bye!
What's the hold up?
This is the beauty of doing something like this. You gotta multitask. as I sit here and do this at the same time. I gotta pull you guys up so I can see what everybody's saying. So like I was saying, GTA 4 is gonna withstand this. It's, I bet I'm gonna be into GTA 6 and I'm still gonna be able to come back to GTA 4 now that it's back on Xbox One and pop the disc in and really have a fun time playing the game. And I've had a lot of fun playing this. I was amazed that even with the ridiculously bad handling these cars have, and I mean it is horrifyingly bad, how much fun it was to get back acclimated to the game and get back in the swing of it, playing all over again, and you know, doing this whole setup all over again and running it through. And like I said, I want to do the walkthrough with the YouTube channel and do each mission and have you guys, you know, really see how the thing is going. And really sharing some of the funness that this game has. Like, it's funny that how much, you know, we have kind of forgotten how much this game has to offer. So I don't know. I just find it hilarious that we could just pick this right back up and throw it down and have an enjoyable time with it. And that's the ode to an enjoyable game. I really am hoping that even if they make a GTA 6 online, that just like this one, I can go online here and still play using the online feature. I'm hoping that GTA 5 does the same thing. Like, it still allows you to go back in and, you know, use your characters and do other things like that. I still have, from time to time, popped into, still popped in back to the 360 online universe. And it's funny because I still have 19 million there and played that game and said, you know, wow. Yeah, I can still play Heist. I didn't realize that Heist had already, you know, been out for that. The only thing you can't really do is there's a lot of the Benny stuff and things like that that weren't added to that game because it wasn't really prepared for it yet. But that's the thing, is time is time. So we'll see what it does down the road. So I want you guys to kind of hear this position.
Oh, where the fuck have you been, man?
Yeah, I came as soon as I could.
I don't pay for as soon as I could. Sleep with half the women in Liberty City, no doubt.
What's wrong with you, man? You're acting like an asshole.
You think I don't know that? You think I like being like this?
Then what's wrong, T?
I fucked up. Good and proper. I work Algonquin nightlife 20 years. I beat everyone. Mayors, rivals, drugs, everyone. And this time, I fucked up. I'm the only man in the history of this town with the hottest gay and straight clubs at the same time, and I'm about to lose everything.
What are you talking about, T?
I don't know if it's that idiot Evan, or the economy, or this fucking cocaine, or the pills, which I am not taking anymore, but this time, I fucked up. Oh. Oh. I've done a deal with the wrong devil, man. I'm such an idiot.
Things have been bad before, man. You get us out of it. I fight. You plot, together we get out of it.
Sure, but we've never been this fucked before.
Hey, you saved me, man. Made me. Gay Tony will always be the king of this town. You are this town.
I sold a business to two different people, and they each think they own the lot. Man, we're fucked.
So I'll go tell them they gave you the money as a present. And if they don't like it, I take them to the special VIP room at the bottom of the West River.
It's gonna be very crowded in the VIP room. These are not nice people, and there's a lot of them. And right now, you and me have to go play nice with one of them so they don't start sending Rent a Goomba into the club. Fuck.
It's gonna be okay, man.
Yeah, whatever. Meanwhile, there's this blogger, this nebbish with an internet connection, bad-mouthing me all over town. Do you know this guy? The celebrinator?
Celebr what?
Whatever. Come on. All right, who's the girl?
There wasn't a girl, man.
There's always a girl.
Poor Luis, he's always getting run over by Gay Tony.
We're meeting Rockwell at the driving range. My fruit laptop.
So that's the real question: is how many of you have actually picked up or gone back and actually purchased GTA 4 or the complete edition and started replaying this. And I know there's a good group of people. One of my friends that actually logged on earlier sold his game to GameStop and then went back out and repurchased it back from them because he wanted to play this again because it's one of his favorite games. In fact, he likes this more than he likes GTA 5. So, and I find it funny that that's feasible. Like, we're going back and picking up the game, you know what I mean?
Oh, Rock, hey, how are you?
There they are, the spick and the
That's
bay.
The thing is I really need to get...
Shit.
I think it's Chinatown Stories. I can't remember the name. I played one that was on one of the Nintendo systems, and that was kind of crazy. It was a little bit like old school because you didn't have you had the still the top down and everything. So I kind of felt like I was playing that GTA 1, GTA 2 thing. But that was a blast to play. So
overinflated opinion of himself. These fucking guys stuck in the 1970s or something.
Where is he?
He's right.
The other thing I need to remind people, too, is that I believe it's March 7th. The system is going to stop allowing for transfers from your characters over to PS3 to PS4. Or excuse me, PS4, Xbox One, and PC. You can take your characters from one side to the next. Like, a PS4 character can go to PC. An Xbox 360 character can go to, I think, pretty much every system. So, but what I've been hearing, and I'm trying to have a position on confirming this, though, because it seemed like really weird.
What are we doing, man?
The way I read it was that they were going to delete the characters.
Who ain't playing
and
ball,
I haven't heard that anywhere. So if you've heard that and you believe that's true or think that's true, then let me know and reference where those sections were so I can see it myself, because it'd be the first time that I've heard about it. I know, like I said, I do know that they are moving the characters over and that that's going to be, you know, the end of it. But whether that's the end of 360 didn't really roll with me, so I don't think so. I just, that's the other thing, deleting characters, it just seems like a bad idea to me. So, and a lot of people are saying move the characters just to keep them from getting, from losing them. And, I mean, if that's true, finding somebody else's Xbox and logging on and getting it, just change it over. So that you can convert it to later, you know what I mean? It seems like a really good idea, so it would kind of bug me to lose my 360 character, so.
Wabba-boom! There's got to be someone higher up. Give them to me!
You fucking assholes!
In this mission, I've played this a couple of times, too. There's a way to get this guy over here not to die. And I'm going to try to have him survive this one, too.
I wouldn't want to be you. We're going to do something about that. Shit! Give me a fucking hand here! Much as it pains me, we better get down there.
That's the sucky part right now, ammo.
Oh, I grab it.
Got you surrounded, asshole. Weaselly son of a bitch.
I don't think I'm gonna live through this.
Bring it.
Man, this is cutting it close. Oh, I'm literally rubbing against the life and death curve here. Taking the shortcut because it really does protect you a lot better than going the other way.
I don't want to die in a golf cart. That's it. Go. Go. Yep. Go. We might be in the clear.
I think I made it. Wow.
Jesus Christ.
Push it, Lou. Come on. We're nowhere near top speed in this thing.
Oh, really, though? When you become the golf buggy specialist?
Oh, I don't know. Just get us out of here and shut up. I think we lost him. That was a pleasant outing, Rock. Where's that put us with you know what? We square?
Square? What you borrowed? At
so see, he's
points,
alive here.
You ain't even making a dent on the interest. Besides, I'm about to have to do all the messy work on this guy myself.
No, but I told you shit. I told you everything.
I'll see you girls later.
Jesus!
So that what happens with that is if you don't blow the other guy up, if you don't blow up the first vehicle in the group, he lives and he's around to talk when he gets back to the thing. It's not a big change, and I don't know if it does anything else, but it's good to see that there's options, you know?
The emphasis is on business, bro. You can keep your crabs to yourself.
Sorry, man, but I really got
so that's really the question is should there be that kind of transitional character move from GTA 5 to GTA 6? And then if we have that transition, how's it going to be handled? So, and the other thing is they really dedicated to the true diamond, you know, MMO game where it's just and we've heard so many mixed messages too about what the plan is. So there's possibilities that it could be, you know, still a single player game that allows the three character choices like we have now and then still having the online. But I still want to see that storyline. I want to see that mission connection that's going on in the online universe that I really just don't see, you know, anywhere else in GTA other than the single player. And it's what we get attached to. So, and it's why I play the game. And I know I can keep coming back. I mean, obviously we're not playing online here. We're back, you know, playing GTA single player for GTA 4. So it's got to say something. And that's the thing is, there's always been a big argument about this game about what were the strengths and weaknesses of the online version for GTA 4. It was a very, very early test kind of setup that was generating a way of us to play online that correct me if I'm wrong here, there was no other you know, situational that allowed us to do that in any other GTA. And I think it's funny because I've been playing Midnight Club way back in the day. I want to say it was like 02 with PlayStation, playing it online. And I mean, we didn't get to until we got to GTA 4 before we had an online GTA. And that's, I'd already been saying, like, if you're not making an online game, you know, then there's no point even making a game anymore. I just think it's the other thing that makes it funny to me is how many people were kind of not aligned with that microtransaction thing, that they really looked at, you know, GTA and said, wow, you guys are really going after the money, aren't you? And to me, it was kind of, I mean, they gave us an option. It wasn't dedicated. So, I mean, if they really wanted to stick it to us, they will still be charging us the same way that they did before, right? So, this is the other thing is that in GTA 4, you didn't have the health options you had in the other games. You had to go buy food. And then, of course, the dude gets in a fight with you because you bumped into his car. oh, there's... I gotta get that. You are not getting away.
Please proceed.
Okay, let's do it that way then. It's my Shafter. I'm a Shafter fan. Which is why we're playing the Ballad of Gay Tony and not another version, because that's all this game is about, is playing variations on the Shafter, which is... And I don't know if Rockstar got mad at me once because I referenced the cars that their cars look like. But you know what? I don't think I have the if you will, the attachments that I used to. So this is a Mercedes S-Class all day long, and everybody knows it. So I used to own one, and every time I get on here, this version is the version that I owned, and owned an S600. And every time I see the Shafters, I see the Shafter V12 and those variants, and it just reminds me so much of my car that it's like, I'm grabbing it, I'm in it, you know? That's the other thing. I'd love to see this retro Shafter be put into GTA Online. If I had kind of my choice, that's where I'd go. Everybody's looking at me like I'm weird about that, but... They've done so well with the car selection. There's a lot of places that they could do new things. And obviously, like I said, with Steve from Los Santos, GTA Wise Guy, those guys that have put input into the game to make our experience a better game. I mean, you got to commend them for it. And I want to see more people giving us ideas like that. And it's just made it so that the game is so... All our options are there. We can play pretty much any kind of car that's out there that's, you know, at least some variation of whatever we want to play. Sure, I'd like to see a Nissan 240 SX style character, but if I don't, I'm not losing any sleep. And the new Spectre kind of looks like an RX-7, and it looks like a couple other cars, so it kind of falls into that zone of, you know, how much fun it is. I wish they would fix... The downforce stuff and the wing, the spoiler modifications and junk like that, or mix some of the stuff together so we can have cooler cars. But I think, and people are going to argue with me on this, but I've said it before, a lot of this stuff that I see people do is these esport things. And esports cool. I want to see a variation for that for Grand Theft Auto. Not above yourself. Loose either. I want to see it kind of put in a way that it can be strong. I wouldn't probably be, I mean, I used to be the deathmatch guy, but I ended up playing more with racing, and I had a lot more fun with racing because it's, you don't get the kind of hate speech that you get on racing that you get in that, or if you do missions or heists or something like that. A lot of people work together with you to get something done, so it's a lot funner. Chiseled. But even then, I'd like to see some sort of race series. Guys like Brophy and those guys do stuff, but there's nothing out there that's real. I mean, we do the World Championship, which is 11 months, one event a month. that is dedicated about how it's set up, and it has different options. There's a lot of role playing in it. There's different things you have to do, and you have to show your all around ability to be good at it to win that world championship. So that stuff's out there, and I'd like to see something like what we're doing put into the regular GTA universe and to allow people to be competitive. That's why I've created a point system for it, because I wanted to allow people over. I wanted to be able to give that point system to somebody else, tell them how to put it together, and then say, okay, these players over here do this for points, and these players over here do this for points. The problem with that is obviously you really need to police points, because it's not that people are, I don't want to say this in the wrong way, it's not that people are bad at points, it's that people get carried away with points. So once you get in a game, you start thinking, I'm going to award people stuff, and they're going to want people. I mean, I've seen people give away the craziest stuff just to say, hey, you're going to be in my crew. I've seen people give away the Yankton cars, which, I mean, obviously whatever they gave got lost in the transition. So I want to tell people that run a crew like that, if you do a crew where people are in it to get stuff, as soon as the stuff goes away, they're not in your crew anymore. And that's the thing is I don't want that crew to be, or that point system to be something that people take and, can I use another car? Nope, I gotta use this car. Damn it. I don't want them to be have something and say, I'm gonna use that point system and say, hey, if you play in my league, you'll get more points than any place else. And the thing is that's the zeal and a positive thing that new players are trying to bring to it. I don't want to look at them and say those are bad. Oh, yeah, they're giving away more points than anybody else. They're bad people. They're doing something that they believe tactically allows more people to play in their setup. Do you know what I mean? So I'm not going to get mad at them for that, because that's the incentive that they want to present to people, and that's okay. Whatever works for you. But in a point system, you have to not touch the points. The points have to be sacrosanct. They have to be untouchable. They have to be, this is the way things are, and they have to stay that way. If you want to provide more events than anybody else in your group, then yeah, let's do that. You know, offer them other things that allow them to be dedicated to your system, but don't give stuff away, because the more stuff you give away, the more you ruin it for everybody else. So that's the thing, that's the problem with the system, is you have to be able to police it better than I think that one person can do. And that's the other thing, is when I did one crew, I mean, we currently have three people that do it, and that's the way it balances out. I mean, it's on different forms. It's not just GTA. It's Forza. It's the crew. It's Need for Speed. And all that point system really does transpire over well for each different system. But I'd like to see that. And if you're hearing this and you say, I want to implement the point system, I have no problem telling you exactly how to put it together, how to make it work, how to drive, you know, more people to play your game, because they're getting something that they're not going to get any place else. And that's really what the bonus of it is for them to be able to say, what do you call it? It's, you have the ability to do what you want to do. You know, there's the reward for it. It's not that you're offering something in a bonus. You're offering something that nobody else is offering, and a universal point system that, you know, that we can put to whole different games and systems and all sorts of fun stuff, you know what I mean? And continue to have a very enjoyable experience. Cross-platform, cross-game systems, you know, and then have a world's championship that we've put together, that you say, hey guys, if you want to do this, this option is there, you know. So yeah, so if that's something that sounds like it'll be interesting to you, and it's something that you think that, you know, you would want to get dialed in on, please let me know. And we can continue to, you know, offer people an enjoyable experience, you know? Because that's the thing. That's really what it is. It's platform playing. It's us sharing some of our great options and great things together to make, you know, a great team play system. Where's this dude with the rocket? I'm going to go all the way up. I don't think he's up there, but I think I shot him. But now I don't want to go all the way up. I was really looking forward to getting that that rocket launcher. And I did last time too. Nope, he's not up here. I shot him from the ground last time, so I think that's what gave it to me. So unfortunately this will not be the last playthrough I do. And it has to be not the last playthrough, because I definitely want to play through this and give you guys the same thing we're doing with the crew, so that you can play all the different games in row and line them up and have a blast with it, because it really is a blast to be able to retroactively play through all the stuff on X1 and see the changes and the things that they've made better with it. I mean, this is really just the original game. I mean, runs faster, it runs more streamlined. It just really makes me think that when they designed this game, that it was they needed a better system. You know what I mean? Not that those systems are bad again. Will I live through this, guys? Will Luis live to fight another day? I'm guessing yes.
Take that, you condescending motherfuckers! Fuck yeah, bitch! Knock up and I'll bust on out of here.
Hey, bro. I can't imagine you got much of a business left now that we've taken out all your employees.
Imagination isn't your strong suit, Luis. Let's leave the logistics to me, huh?
Hey, I'm more than happy to leave everything to you, Maury. In fact, I don't want to be no part of any of this shit.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but you and Tony are business partners, aren't you?
Sure.
Well, I own Tony. Ergo, I own your ass as well. Get used to it.
Hey, no one owes me, bro.
Oh, I beg to differ.
Quicksilver looking water.
Here we go, bro. You gonna get out of my face now?
Woo! Sure I am, sure. Hey, you did great. I'm feeling real bullish about you, Lou. Real fucking bullish.
Good to know.
Hey, you come by soon. We got some more shit to discuss.
So I want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight. It was really enjoyable to do a throwback event. I've never done one before. This is my first one. And it was really exciting to play a game that really, like I said, has aged superbly and withstood the test of time. Just to be able to come back now and be able to play it and, you know, feel like it was day one all over again with GTA. Again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in. We're going to be putting this live stream up on YouTube patreon.com/VIP Primo. So if you want to view it later, and don't forget to tune in every Wednesday night at 10 p.m. to see more of GTA and other games. And we'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.